And lawmakers will hear tonight what Iowans think about a proposal to eliminate statewide preschool.
News Channel 8's Angie Hunt talked to parents and educators who feel that this is a bad move. Angie?
That's right, Kevin. There's a concern that a lot of children would be left out, but Republican lawmakers say taxpayers shouldn't have to pay for preschool for those families who can afford it. Teachers say the skills children develop in preschool
swallowed a bird.
Good job.
Help build the foundation for a lifetime of learning.
Their brains are going to take in the most birth to five, and so why not fill those brains full and get them ready?
Having taught preschool for more than a decade, Audra Watson feels it would be a step back to end the statewide preschool program. It's likely many students at the Northwood Preschool Center in Ames would be left out.
It would be very difficult for us to find the right option that would fit our family's needs.
It will be difficult for me to put him here if they pull the universal funding.
Katie Murphy's son will attend Northwood next fall. She doubts she would qualify for help for lower-income families. But seeing how the preschool has helped her daughter, she doesn't want her son to miss out on that opportunity, even if funding is cut.
I mean, I'll have to pull it from somewhere because I really want him to come here.
Without the funding from the state, about half the students here at Northwood wouldn't be able to attend preschool, and that would likely lead to cuts in staff.
If we do not get the funding, it would be doubtful what our program would look like.
But educators say they see evidence every day of how the program is helping young learners get off to a good start.
I think if we could have some longevity and just really see what a difference we're making for kids and families.
We've had a lot of kids that we do some instruction interventions on them, and they end up not needing services when they go on to elementary school.
Now, Republican lawmakers say there would be help for low-income families to pay for preschool, but there are no details as to who would qualify. Now, if you'd like to give your thoughts on these spending cuts, you can attend tonight's public hearing. It starts at 6:30 in the House chambers.
Angie Hunt from the Ames Live Link tonight. Thanks, Angie.